Hi guys, I hope you all are doing well and keeping safe. So welcome to the new video of Road to Express Entry series. In the last video, I discussed with you how to apply for an ITA, and as I told you, I received my invitation to apply, and now is the time to apply actually for my permanent residency. So with the invitation to apply, I get a document checklist which tells me which documents will I require finally to apply for my permanent residency. So today I'll be going over the very first and a very important document for you to submit for your permanent residency application, which is PCC, also known as Police Clearance Certificate, which we get from India or from any other country to which you belong to. So basically, a police clearance certificate is a certificate which the officials of your country provide to the Canadian immigration, saying or stating that you were not involved in any criminal activity back in your own country. So it is a very important document for immigration purposes, and this is something we have to apply well in advance because it takes approximately 6 weeks for you to get it. So today I'll show you the entire process of applying for a PCC and how we get it. So let's start. Alright, so since I don't have the checklist with me, I have opened the official CIC page where you see that what documents are required for your application for permanent residence, and you can see the police certificates here. So PCC is one of that, and I'll now be showing you which websites to go to. So the next thing that you will be doing is you will be going to the BLS International Services Canada website. Again, I will be putting the link in description. So once you are on the website, you go to passport and then you go to police clearance certificate. So when you are here, you get all the information about police clearance certificate, and from here you see that which jurisdiction you are under. So you see that where you are living currently in Canada. We have different BLS application centers for different jurisdictions, so you check that. For example, for me, because I live in Ottawa, for me the BLS application center was Ottawa or Montreal because I live in one of these areas. Alright, now I know my jurisdiction. Here you can also check the requirements, but anyways, you will see the requirements in the checklist once you download it. If you want to check the fees, you can see it here. The fees for police clearance certificate is Canadian dollars 41.40, and you have to get a demand draft made in the name of BLS Canada. So you go to your bank and you get a demand draft made. Then you see the processing time. It's almost 4 to 6 weeks, and then you have the forms and checklist. So here is what you have to do. Since your jurisdiction is Ottawa, for example, in my case, whatever your jurisdiction is, do according to that. So first thing is that you have to click here and go for the police clearance application form. So this is embassypassportindia.gov.in website. Don't worry, I'll be putting all the links in the description. So what you have to do here is you have to select the region from where you wish to apply for the passport services. So for us, it is going to be Canada. So we'll select this, and after that, it will ask you to log in. So if you have already an account on the passportindia.gov website, it's well and good, you just have to log in. But if you don't have an account, I would advise you to go to register, and then you can register for your account. Once this is done, you have to go to user login. So you log in here using your user ID and password. Alright, once you are in your account, you will see that here are a lot of applications that you can apply, and the one which we need to apply is the apply for police clearance certificate. You see, I've already applied, so I have my file number and everything here. For you, you have to click on apply for police clearance certificate here, and then you will have a form that you'll need to fill. So it's quite a long form. You can go one by one. So the first thing is going to be your passport details, which you're going to share. Purpose of PCC is going to be immigration, and the passport number, for example, I am just writing here an example, and then you write date of expiry. File number, country for which PCC is required is Canada, and date of issue then you have the applicant details. Okay, so I would advise you to fill out this form yourself. So this entire form, we have the passport details, applicant details, family details, residential details, other details, PCC details, and PCC details verification. So in this column, PCC details and PCC details verification, they are going to ask you that which is the police station which is nearest to your residence in India, or the police station of which is under your area where you live in India. So that those are the details that you have to provide here, and then an inspector from that police station can verify your file. So once all of this is done, your file is actually created and this thing is done. Alright guys, so when you fill out all the fields of this form, finally you will get one form, and in that form you will have all the information. So I would suggest you to thoroughly check that form, and if everything looks right there, once everything is there, you can take a printout of that form, because that is going to act as your application form. That is the main form which you will have to attach with the checklist required for PCC, and which you will have to send then to BLS Canada. So after checking it thoroughly, after submitting it, do take a printout of that form, and then also when you submit it, you will have now a copy on the indianpassport.gov.in website. You will have a file number there, so you can also track the status of your PCC once everything is done here only. Then you come back and go to the checklist, which you will find here. So if you click here, you will get the PCC checklist. Yes, so this is the checklist. I would advise you to take a printout of this checklist, because we have to attach it with the other forms which we are going to submit to BLS. So in this checklist, you see, you write your name, email address, passport number, and mobile number. Then these are the things which are required. So the first thing is the application form. This is the same form which we just filled out, and you will get a printout and you will attach it with this form here. So once you do it, you can take this. Second, you will need two photos of this size, which is 51 by 51. So you can go to your nearest pharmacy to get these pictures clicked. Third thing that you will need is copy of the Indian passport, and here also take care what pages you need the copy of. So it says that front and last page, and all the pages where you have Canadian visa and immigration stamps. So if ever you are entering Canada, or wherever you have the visa stamps for Canada, do have a copy of that as well, and then attach it with this form. So once it is done, you can take this as well. Then is your status in Canada. So for me, since I am on work permit, I did I did get a photocopy of my work permit and I attached it with this form. So you can do that as well if you are on work permit. Then the last thing is fees. So as I suggested previously, we have to pay the amount of $41.40 by a demand draft, because we are doing the file, we are just sending it by courier to BLS Canada. So we'll do it by demand draft, or otherwise if you're handing it over by going yourself to BLS Canada, in that case you can do it by cash or by debit card only. Then this was not applicable for me, but it says that you need a notarized affidavit for change in appearance. And then the last one is proof of address. So for the proof of address, you can provide either of the following. The proof of address means the address where you are currently living in Canada. So for this, you can provide either your driving license or a photo ID issued by the Ontario government. It can be your health card, or you can also submit your utility bills. For example, if you got any electricity, water, gas, phone or internet bills, but they must be latest. Alright, so once this is done, you just sign here and attach all the checklist documents with this checklist. Tick all the fields and then we are good to go. Alright guys, so when everything is ready, your envelope with all the forms, everything is ready, you need to call BLS Canada and tell them your file number, your details, give them everything, and they will be arranging a Purolator agent to come to your home to collect the envelope from you. So yes, they'll be fixing that up. All you need to do is to pay them over the phone through your credit or debit card and pay them for the Purolator services. Once everything is fixed, you will soon after receive an email from Purolator giving you the exact day and time when an agent from Purolator would be coming to pick up the envelope. And also in that email will be a label, the mailing label, which you will be attaching on the envelope so that your envelope can be delivered to BLS Canada. And also while they are doing the entire thing for you, you are also paying for Purolator to bring your PCC back to you when everything is done, when all the procedure has taken place in India. Purolator guy would be coming to deliver your PCC back to you. So everything is sorted, all of that is done by Purolator. So guys, this was the entire process of applying PCC. I know the process is very simple, it's just that you guys need a little guidance, and I know that you can do it yourself. You don't need any assistant from any agent to apply a PCC for you. So if you like the video and if you think it was useful in any way, please hit the like button. Do comment if you need any help with PCC any further, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel for more such videos. Take care. Bye.